Can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Given a circle, now let's draw an equilateral triangle inside of it, wherein one of its vertex is on the circumference of our circle, and this distance, or this length, is 2 centimeters, and this length is 3 centimeters. The question is, what is the area of our circle? Pause this video right now and see if you can answer this question, because I will show you the answer and the solution in 3, 2, 1. Alright, so by the way, this question is from our subscriber, and he wants to solve this question in multiple ways. And by the way, the answer to this question is 19 pi centimeters squared. And the question is, how do we get 19 pi centimeters squared? Now, let me show you 3 different methods to answer this kind of question. So let's have the first method. The first method is the Pythagorean theorem. We love Pythagorean theorem for sure. The second is the cosine law. So different from the Pythagorean theorem. And the last one, we have a Stewart theorem. Now, let's begin with the Pythagorean theorem. Alright, so again, Pythagorean theorem is a squared plus b squared equals c squared, wherein a, b, and c are the side length of our right triangle, wherein c is the hypotenuse. Now, to get the area of the circle, we need the radius. So let's connect the center to this intersection point, and let's call this as r. Now, we don't care to this circle, we care to the radius. So let's focus to this equilateral triangle. Now, since this is an equilateral triangle, we know all of this interior angle measures 60 degrees. Now, let's drop a perpendicular line given to this point, like this. Now, at this point, we created a special right triangle, which is 30, 60, 90 right triangle. And the hypotenuse is 2 centimeters. Therefore, the side opposite of the 30 degrees simply equal to 1 centimeter. And the side opposite of this 60 degrees is square root of 3 centimeters. Now, we have an equilateral triangle, and the side of this equilateral triangle is 5, because 2 plus 3 is 5. Since we have now 1, therefore, this side, or this length, measures 4 centimeters. Now, let's focus to this right triangle. And since this is a right triangle, we can now use what we call the Pythagorean theorem. So, using Pythagorean theorem, we have square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared equals r squared. Simplify, we have 3 plus 16 equals r squared. 3 plus 16 will give us 19, which is equal to r squared. Now, we know the value of r squared. And to get the area of a circle is equivalent to pi r squared. We know r squared is 19, therefore we can say that the area of this circle simply equal to 19 pi square centimeters, and that is our answer to this question. So using Pythagorean theorem, we get that the area of the circle is 19 pi square centimeters. Alright, now how about the second solution using cosine law? So let's begin. Cosine law is equivalent to a squared equals b squared plus c squared minus 2bc times cosine of angle A, or the angle opposite of side A. Now, again, to find the area of the circle, we need the radius. Now, let's focus again to this equilateral triangle, because we know this angle measures 60 degrees. And now, we know also the length of this equilateral triangle, or the length of the side. This is just 2 plus 3, or simply equal to 5. And now, let's focus on this triangle, because using this triangle, we can now use what we call the cosine law. So, using cosine law, we have r squared equals 2 squared plus 5 squared minus 2 times 5 times 2 multiplied by the cosine of this angle, 60 degrees. Simplify this result. We have r squared equals 4, this is 25, minus 2 times 2 times 5, and cosine 60 is 1 over 2, or 1 half. Simplify further, we have 29 minus 10, and 29 minus 10, this will give us 19, and that is the value of r squared. Again, we know the value of r squared equals 19, and the area of the circle is pi r squared. Therefore, the area of the circle simply equal to 19 pi square centimeters. So using our second method, we get the same result. Now, let's begin with the third solution. We have the Stewart theorem. So let's start. To memorize the formula for the Stewart theorem, you can use this sentence: a man and his dad put a bomb in the sink. So this corresponds to this figure, and that is the Stewart theorem. Now let's use the Stewart theorem to answer this question, or to find the value of r and find the area of the circle. So again, we need the radius. Alright, now let's focus to this equilateral triangle again. Now, we know the length of the side of this equilateral triangle are all equal to 5 centimeters. Now, what we're going to do is to use what we call the Stewart theorem. This is very straightforward. So, using this, take note this D corresponds to our R, this M corresponds to 3, and this N corresponds to 2. Now, C and B is just 5 and 5. So using the Stewart theorem, we have 3 times 5 times 2 plus 5 r squared equals 5 squared times 3 plus 5 squared times 2. Now focus on this result and let's find the value of r. Simplify this, we have 30 because 6 times 5 is 30. Bring down 5 r squared. We have 25 times 3 is 75. And we have here 50, therefore we end up with 125. Subtract 30 on both sides, we have 5 r squared equals 95. Divide 5 on both sides, we get r squared again equals 19. Now, we know r squared equals 19, therefore the area of this circle simply equal to 19 pi square centimeters. Therefore, given this figure and using three different methods, we get that the area of the circle simply equal to 19 pi square centimeters. And before we end this video, let's have an extra challenge. And the extra challenge is to find another solution to solve for the area of this circle. Because take note, more solution, more fun. So I will read your answer in the comment section down below. And as always, we are done.